Bridgerton was the biggest show on Netflix last year. Part of that was because the series was based on a very popular book series. While the show was great and all, there were a lot of things that even the book fans didn't see coming. In this video, we're going to be taking a closer look at 8 of the biggest differences between the Bridgerton books and the series, and some other news about the series you might have missed. So let's get into it. 8. Anthony knew about Daphne and Simon's fake relationship. In the show, Daphne and Simon keep their fake relationship completely under the radar, especially from Daphne's brother Anthony, who has a habit of making his hatred for their marriage known to the whole world. But even though he's supposed to be someone that would be able to snuff them out, he never does, which was something a lot of fans considered a bit of a cop-out on the showrunner's part. However, things are totally different in the book. In the book, Anthony uses his prehistoric detective skills and figures out the two are together and totally flips out about it. He gets so angry about it that Simon and Daphne end up telling him that their relationship is actually fake so that he would drop it and back off. To make things even more convincing, they also made Anthony swear that he wouldn't tell anyone, which he surprisingly ended up fulfilling, keeping their ruse going on for much longer than expected. 7. Marina Thompson is a completely different character. Possibly one of the biggest changes the showrunners ever made was probably just how different the Marina Thompson on the show is compared to the character in the Bridgerton books. In the Netflix series, Marina is a cousin of Featherington who is unwillingly sent to London by her father to find a husband. What Marina's father didn't know was she was already pregnant. Long story short, she basically got pregnant by a soldier, George Crane. Obviously, in the 19th century, this was extremely looked down upon. Thompson and Crane had been regularly sending each other letters until one day he stopped responding. Well, turns out George literally died on the battlefield. Now Marina is adamant about trying to find a way to fix her reputation. She tries everything from trying to end her pregnancy to tricking Colin into marrying her just so she could save her honor. However, things didn't really work out that way, and in a twisted turn of events, she ended up marrying George Crane's younger brother, Phillips Crane. Not gonna lie, that's probably one of the most messed up things in the show overall. In the books, even though she is engaged to Phillips Crane after George dies, but Marina ends up committing suicide in the 5th book to Sir Philip with love after she found out that Phillips was in a relationship with Eloise through letters. That's not all. She even had crippling depression basically her whole life, and she was a distant relative of the Bridgertons, not the Featheringtons. 6. Simon's father actually cared about his wife in the books. In the show, Simon's father is shown as a pretty insensitive man, like he didn't even care that his wife of 15 years and the one with whom he had 4 daughters died of a hemorrhage after giving birth. Why? Because she finally gave birth to a baby boy who could be an heir to his throne. He celebrates the birth of his son while his wife is literally dying alone in the same building. However, in the books, while Simon's parents don't actually love each other, his father mourned his wife's death after she gave birth to their son. He was actually affected as opposed to not caring and just going back to business as if nothing happened. 5. Violet didn't want Daphne and Simon to end up together. In the show, Violet Bridgerton probably ships Daphne and Simon even more than we do. She wanted Daphne to get married by her choice, just like she did when she married Edmund Bridgerton. Violet literally used to invite Simon over for dinner, making his favorite pie for him, and she even told Daphne that she should stop giving other men that much attention, or it could hurt Simon's feelings. But did you know that in the books, she used to specifically tell Daphne not to go see Simon? Violet used to see Simon as Anthony Bridgerton's best friend, who was a really annoying and spoiled character. So it wouldn't be surprising if she thought that Simon was also like Anthony, but she did eventually come around to liking him. She just had a really bad first impression of him, to say the very least. 4. Queen Charlotte doesn't even exist. Van Dusen added a bunch of original characters that Julia Quinn's books didn't have. One of the characters that he added to the show was Queen Charlotte. Queen Charlotte was arguably one of the most loved characters in the entire show because she was a very just queen and made sure there were no prejudices against people of color. Although she didn't exist in the books, she was actually a real person, the first ever black monarch who ruled Ireland and England with her husband King George in the 1700s. Julia Quinn even said in an interview that she wished she added Queen Charlotte in the books because of how much she liked her character. Van Dusen said he saw this character as an opportunity to marry history and fantasy. Adding Queen Charlotte as another character is probably the best decision Dusen ever had. 3. There's no boxing at all. Almost all of Simon's life details are exactly the same as the book, except one. Simon is shown in a lot of the scenes, boxing off some of the stress that comes from being such an important figure. But here's the thing. In Julia Quinn's books, Simon never boxed. Instead of boxing, what he did have was a lot of knowledge about boating. However, boxing was a very respected sport in the 1800s, so it's not that surprising that Van Dusen decided to add that detail to his character. 2. Simon and Daphne introduction is much different. In the books and the show, the first time Daphne and Simon meet is when Daphne rejects Lord Nigel's proposal. But everything unfolds in different ways. In the show, Daphne first runs into Simon after she was trying to run away from Lord Nigel. In the books, Simon just happens to hear Daphne and Nigel's conversation and steps in after Daphne knocks Nigel out after punching him in the face. 1. Nurse Hopkins helps Simon with his stammer, not Lady Danbury. As a child, Simon actually had a pretty bad stutter. His father, Lord of Hastings, even rejected his son for having a stutter and called him an idiot. Having literally no one to help him out with his severe stammer, Lady Danbury helps him overcome his stutter. As an adult, Simon no longer has even a hint of stutter at all. This isn't the case in the books, where he practiced his speech with Nurse Hopkins, who isn't really an important character, so you might have even missed her, although he did mention her as a kind-hearted woman who used to invite her over for dinner and even take on the role as his mother at times. But that's not the only thing that the show changed. In the books, Simon was never actually able to fully get rid of his stutter. He always had a little hint of it. Because of the slight stutter he still had, he was also much less social than in the series. Some other Bridgerton news. Since we're already on the topic of Bridgerton, here's some other news that has just recently come out about the show. Bridgerton Season 2 is coming out real soon, with the first season being such a hit. It's no surprise that everyone wants a Season 2 already. Fortunately, Bridgerton had already been renewed for another season in early 2021, and the filming process just finished this November, so you don't have to wait much longer for the next season. The filming began around the spring of 2021, but it had to be paused in July because two of the crew members actually tested positive for the virus. But fortunately, they picked it up again in early August. But because of the pause, the release date has also been postponed from Christmas 2021 to hopefully early to mid-2022. Regé Jean will not be appearing as Simon in Season 2, even though the second season of Bridgerton was always supposed to be about Anthony's love story and shifting away from Daphne and Simon, it's still pretty heartbreaking to hear that our favorite Duke won't be appearing for the next season at all. Apparently, he only signed a one-year contract deal for the series, so he was never actually even supposed to show up for the second season. And even though he was offered an offer to appear as a guest in Season 2, he ended up declining it. And that's a wrap for this video. What do you think we're in for in Season 2? Do let us know down in the comments below. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up and click the subscribe button for more videos like this. See you next time.